Yeah, she plays Ellie, I believe, in the Last of Us series, which just premiered over the weekend. I think it did somewhere in like 4 to 5 million viewers, which I don't know how successful that is, but I'm assuming that's way below things like Game of Thrones and other popular series. But this was, I guess, a big story that trended right before the show, is that Bella Ramsey, while doing promo work for the series, decided to come out as non-binary. Now, no one can explain to me exactly what the fuck non-binary means. So I'm just gonna assume that it means that ugly women who are too ugly to identify as feminine, and just wanna jump ahead of this and claim as masculine. So I mean, I don't know, but in an interview with the New York Times, the actor said that they identify as binary and does not mind any pronoun. So you're non-binary, but you'll use it. Okay, sure, whatever. I guess my gender has always been very fluid, Ramsey says. Someone would call me she and her, and I wouldn't much think anything of it. Why would you? I don't think any normal girl would think anything of that, but I knew that if someone called me a he, it was a bit exciting. I'm very much a person. This actress is like 19 years old, so keep that in your mind as well. Being gendered isn't something that I particularly like, but in terms of pronouns, I really couldn't care less than why I bring it up, I guess.
Yeah, exactly. Why is it the most obsessive thing about, you know, please continue.
Oh, no, that's pretty much the whole story here, that she just falls into the LGBTQ plus never-ending representation umbrella. Like you said, it's just consuming our society right now. So yeah, you actually saw The Last of Us, so go ahead and tell us what you think about this story here.
Well, it's like if you don't care about gender and pronouns, then why do you adhere to it? You know, like why are you so weak-minded as to just simply fall in line? That's what I hate about like all these celebrities. They're not people to look up to because they're just hive mind losers that just follow what's acceptable. None of them dare to stand up for themselves in any real way. It's like, so judging from the first episode, I think that the show is actually pretty good. I enjoyed it for what it was. It followed the game relatively well. And instead of actually discussing, you know, the success that the first episode has brought and discussing, you know, what she had to do in order to, you know, make this happen, you know, bring Ellie to life at, you know, as a person instead of like a video game character. She wants to talk about her fucking pronouns. And it's just pathetic to me because it's like at the end of the day, with what you're saying to me, you're a tomboy. That's really what it is in the grand scheme of things. But adhering to modern day political nonsense, you have to bring in your pronouns and, you know, this whole thing about being non-binary. I don't give a shit. Like, it's just so stupid to me. Nobody cares. I think that honestly, I think that that's the thing. No real person that, you know, has a real life that, you know, actually realizes that Twitter is nonsense in the grand scheme of things. This is a waste of everyone's time. So when you want to give these interviews and you don't want to talk about the actual show, the context, how it was working with stars, how you know you managed to do what you do, because I think that she so far, judging by her portrayal, I think that she does a good, she's pretty good at playing Ellie, and I thought that she was going to be the weakest link. So I mean, you know, what did you do in order to hone your craft to play this character? I didn't get any of that here. It's just. No, you're just going to talk about how you don't understand what gender is. Congratulations, you're an idiot.
Anyone else want us to take this one about the brick face actress girl,
Well,
non-binary?
I will say this, and look, this is kind of what I do on Twitter. I you know, say inflammatory things to get attention, especially negative
The majority
attention.
of Twitter. I respect you for that, Rob, because you don't have an OnlyFans and you leave your shirt on when you do it. So
No.
thank you.
And one of my favorite things is when people attack my personal appearance instead of like my ideas. However, when my ideas are like so basic as to she, damn, that girl's ugly. It's amazing the amount of people that come after you and just want to insult you. And it's like, is this girl like protected or something? Like, and I don't feel like it's that controversial. It's a visual medium. The fact that you're not going to get commented on if you, especially if you stand out as being incredibly ugly. And I like that's objectively speaking, just like unpleasant to look at on any level. So I I would have preferred Caitlin Dever. I think, first of all, I think she's a better actress. Yes. And she looks like Ellie from the game. Yep. But anyway, that's fine.
But she also doesn't look like a foot, so I mean, she wouldn't work in that.
Exactly. So I'm looking forward to watching the pilot episode. I'm hoping it's good. I know HBO can do good work, but you know, we'll just see how it goes.
I wish more reporters would be like, oh, what do you mean by that? Can you explain it to all the racists?
They're not going to explain shit. They're going to be like, yeah, Queen Slay or some nonsense like that.
I know, but like getting them to explain it at least it forces them to be very specific about what they mean by things. Like even with the whole Megan thing.
I'm sorry, but yeah, that was actually. You would actually have to be a fan of the games to understand that reference, but yeah, continue.
It's okay. I don't want to think about Vin Diesel any day of the week, so let alone awake. But, so like getting them to explain what they mean by that would be very helpful on some levels, just because part of the reason that we're in this yes. kind of situation culturally is because when you say things that there's no one set definition for or no universally accepted thing, it's hard for people to not applaud stupidity, you know, in some ways, especially if they say the right words or something, the right buzzwords. And like even asking, like Matt Walsh asking, you know, what is a woman, to these people that were not, you know, going to say what a woman was, is very eye-opening. Because a lot of these people don't necessarily know what they're talking about sometimes. And they just say the right words and they think they'll be okay because they'll be okay. Nobody questions this stuff. Somebody should start saying, oh, what do you mean by that? Would you explain it to the istophobes in our audience for us?
Oh, man.
I said this in the group chat. I said that, like, based on not just this, but like how, and Cassie knows about this too, how these people say all gender non-conforming people, including cross-dressers or trans. And most of these people that are saying this are like ages 16, sometimes 14. I've seen 14-year-olds up in here saying this kind of crap to like 24. It's the Zoomers and the Alphas doing this. So I'm just thinking to myself, what is going on? Is there seriously grooming or like gender indoctrination going on if these kids are saying this? And where are the parents? Seriously.
Well, I mean, look, you got libs of TikTok showing one teacher after another, a preschool kindergarten teacher with rainbow flags and trans flags all over, you know, their classroom and stuff. So these kids have to sit here in these classrooms 5 days a week for 8 hours a day for an 8-month period learning God knows what's being instilled into their minds. And we're just sitting here letting it happen. And then we wonder why these kids are growing up all screwed up in the head. Like,